A rematch of the 2018 FIBA Women's World Cup Final that saw the United States just eat past the Australians. U.S. in the red, white, and blue. The Aussies in the gold and green. So happy to have all of you with us this afternoon here on NBC. And the Aussies start out with a triple from Steph Talbot. Three Seattle Storm members of Team USA and two Seattle Storm players for the Aussies. First, though, let's go down to the Las Vegas Aces star who knows this court well, Asia Wilson.
I'm interested to see how USA basketball responds. Obviously, coming off of a loss to the WNBA All-Stars, they had a spirited practice yesterday and really focused a lot on the defensive end. Two straight possessions of scoring for Australia.
Hand off to Leilani Mitchell. Born in Richland, Washington. The bank is open early today here in Vegas.
Saw Brittany Griner having to come out to defend her, so it's going to be a little bit different from what USA prepared for yesterday.
Bird drops it off to Brittany Griner. Well, if both teams want to shoot this well the entire game, LaChina, I think fans will be okay with that.
Yeah.
Slow things down a bit. Mitchell, the veteran for this Australia team. Great move there, finding Magvigor, who drains the triple. Great start for Team Australia. Off iron. Now Bird in the United States will push. Stewart's drawing the contact, and that's the thing about this international game that I know. Jenna O'Kay, number four in the yellow, also in. Great move down to Brittany Griner, all alone there on the roll.
Beautiful screen by Brittany Griner. USA basketball with so many new players. She's doing a lot of teaching and a lot of mentoring, but she's up for it.
Great shot from Jewel Lloyd. Made that one look easy. In the U.S. Bird saw somebody fall down in front, and that is what happens when you've been playing this game for so long. She looks real quick to pop in.
High IQ play there by Bird.
60% from the floor, 70 from the strike. And hey, Jenna O'Hay can shoot too. Backup point guard for Sue now in. Chelsea Gray, number 8. Mariel Atkins, the lefty floater in the lane. That was pretty.
Tough bucket.
Nigeria men were raining threes here just a couple of days ago. The Opals making it rain here in the first quarter. Shot clock and game clock winding down. And Chelsea Gray says, hey, we can make buckets here for Team USA too.
Team USA adjusts defensively here in the second quarter.
Six made field goals in that first quarter for the Australians as Magvigor is back in and drops in another. Five of them, LaChina, from three-point range. 5 of 10 from distance. So the U.S. dominating in the paint with the absence of Liz Cambage. Again, in case you're just joining us, Chelsea Gray's fadeaway falls in from the baseline. Chelsea Gray, one of them. Great looking three, just a little bit off the mark, but Diggins Smith fighting for that board down on the baseline. Stewie, no good. Great putback by Brianna Stewart.
Her second jump is as quick as anyone you will see in the game.
As we mentioned, born in the state of Washington, started her collegiate career at Idaho, then finished it by winning the Mountain West Player of the Year Award at Utah. And Beck Allen rattles it home. Just over 5.5 to go before the halftime break. Chelsea Gray searching. Stewie letting fly and hitting. Stewart leading all scores with 11. Just a little bit too strong on that last fadeaway attempt. Steph Talbot got the scoring started for Australia. Plays for the Storm, but also was the 2020 MVP of the WNBL as Gray answers right back.
Three-point guards on the floor for USA. That helps you defensively, right, because you're a little smaller. But also, the way you can move the ball and create. Because they did go cold from long range, they're going to have to find a way to get some high percentage looks on the inside.
And a great start to the second half for the Las Vegas Aces star, Asia Wilson. Yeah, what does that tell you, LaChina?
This is another small lineup, another look that helps USA defensively in case Australia starts going off from three. You know, no Brittany Griner out there. It's often hard for your bigs to get out and contest on the three-point line. So they're matching what Australia is putting out there in terms of lineup and mobility.
Speaking of, there is the lefty Ariel Atkins who gets it to go.
No doubt. And it really was because of her defensive intensity, but she can score as well. She is one of the bright young stars.
It's Speaking of scoring, you mentioned Beck Allen might need to take over with Cam Bajat for the Australians. That was pretty stuff from number 9 for the Opals. And now a steal by Steph Talbot. Talbot going end to end for the Opals.
Maybe don't have as much experience, but this group does.
Led by the New York Liberties, Beck Allen drains another long two.
How about the tight handle by Beck Allen at 6'2"?
That she doesn't listen to music before the game, just likes to sit in silence and get into the zone. Asia Wilson, double pump there for Asia. Wilson posting up Magdagore with those three fouls. Great move by the Aces star.
There were letters written by the 96 team to this current team. We talked about how just open you all are. Who did you write your letter to and what did it say?
I wrote my letter to Asia Wilson, and it really just talked about her understanding the blessing that she has to play on this team, to go out there, to work hard every single time, to put into that effort. You know, it's not just about Asia herself, but it's about the whole team. It's about one country and one goal, and that's winning goal.
Lisa, thank you so much. On cue, Asia Wilson scores.
These women getting a platform to inspire, and not just our USA basketball women's team, all women's sports, and especially the U.S., where our women have really been dominant.
Beck Allen knocks down the three.
They got a score inside. USA has not been executing well offensively, with the exception of Asia Wilson and right there by Tina Charles. Coming in undermanned and how you fight. I mean, they're showing a lot of pride.
No Liz Cambage. Kayla George knocks it down. And on cue, LaChana, here comes Australia. Looking forward to bringing you the final exhibition with Nigeria on Sunday. Great movement that time from Talbot down to Magdagore. Again, Sunday right here on NBC Sports as Charles backs it in and gets it to go. Tina Charles, great defense by Magdagore. Ebsery comes away with it. And nice floater off glass by Nigeria. Upset for the Australian Boomers. The men's team, great pass down to Kayla George. When your big's running the floor, you gotta find her.
And no communication or sense of urgency by USA there to get back. And Australia has all the momentum right now.
It's a one-point game. Another defensive stand by the Opals. Emsuri, no. But Talbot there on the follow and the putback. And whatever Sandy Brundle said at the halftime break, LaChina, it certainly helped, because only able to force three United States turnovers in the first half. As Fowl is able to get that offensive rebound and put it back. 60-59 U.S. There's George again running the floor. Mitchell knocks down the triple. Diggin' Smith on her hip. Katie Ray answering. Oh, what a head fake that time by Katie Ray. And things right as he gets set to head to Tokyo next week. A piece of Collier picking up that loose ball to Sue Bird. Bird and Diana Taurasi in search of their fifth gold medal. Big to big, a little high-low action. George caught herself too far under the hoop that time, but what a move to find some space by Kayla George.
Even down the stretch of this one, those get tight.
Sue Bird, no good. Stewart with the offensive rebound in the putback. A massive three-point opportunity for the United States. I had a feeling this was going to be a good one. These two teams have a long history of meeting for medals in Olympic Games. The Opals getting that ball might have had a case. Instead, we play on. Great ball movement by the Opals. Oh my, Tolo with the finish. Gets it to Brianna Stewart, guarded by George. The step back three to tie, no good. And the Opals pull the upset here in Vegas.